Macro Cove, which is a flood zone. You lose power, and also Fort Getty Road is, I believe it's historic road. You'd have to replace all of the telephone poles on that road, put up the larger poles with the T on the top to run the three wires across it. And there was some reservations about doing that at the time.
By the utility company?
By the utility company, by the town.
The town had reservations about putting the higher power lines up with the T style. And then they tried to say, would National Grid pay for that? National Grid bought it.
Right.
Remember, Paul was also concerned that they were scaling up those lines so much that there was, we thought they were gonna be actually transferring power from the West Bay to the East Bay across Jameson, so.
Yeah, I don't really call that part of it, but yeah, there were some issues with running those lines.
Did you say issues with Barrington?
Excuse me?
Did you say issues with Barrington? I sort of listened, but I didn't say the first part of it.
The issues with Barrington, yeah, Barrington across Macro Cove, which is a flood zone, if you're putting those cables at risk anytime it floods over. In the past 10 years, it's gone over a few times.
Martha Beers?
Oh, yeah, you have to do a waterproof cable.
Flooding is more next 10 years.
So.
Yeah, we managed to do waterproof and better for hurricanes.
Yeah.
One, this is probably a good point to call the council's attention to one other model for developing turbines on Jamestown that is just emerged in this last 3 days. I think, talking a little bit about this, I personally think this is something you should be aware of, but it's something for the future. But the way the net metering law works, it only applies to turbines that are owned by towns. But a town's turbines don't have to be located in the town. So in the future, we could consider other towns' turbines at other locations in Jamestown. So you could have two at Fort Getty, one owned by Jamestown and one owned by Providence, and charge them rent for that turbine and charge them, you know, additional fees for access to our wind resource. And that would be yet another way of them being able to take advantage of the net metering law and Jamestown being able to create a win-win there. That's a very complicated undertaking, and it would be a distraction, in my opinion, to pursue it now, but it might be something you hear about in the future.
So you're saying we'd be selling our wind resource, basically.
Right. Some people describe it as condos, condo turbines. Each town has its own condo.
And each community has the ability, right now, under grants and statutes, the ability to bid up to 3.5 meg of passive.
Right.
To get that, then the economic.
Then you're back into a commercial price instruction.
Right. I don't know where that would go with that at this point in time.
I don't think there's anything to do with it, but I didn't want you to not have heard that.
Yeah, there's a lot of that.
So what do we need to do in order to get from here to Monday to get something in by the 1st of March?
I think that the remodeling the economic assumptions for Monday's meeting will be useful. This information that Don has brought over is very recent, as he's indicated, and creating some tables for us showing what the 1.6 megawatt options will provide to us with the did you say that this is the retail rate, or it's not the retail rate?
No, that only adds the era of grant.
That's what I thought, yeah. So this is just done by the true reflection.
Right, and understated.
It's understated.
That, those numbers.
Did we get
So
yeah, I mean, that's that would be helpful. We have the economics, yeah. The environmental information, zoning, and other items that you would address in the feasibility report still stand for each of the sites. So that's already available for council's consideration. And I'm not sure what else we might need for Monday.
I have a couple of things. You talked about the shadow effect, and you discounted or discredited some sites because it affected residents' homes.
Mm-hmm.
And Fort Weatherford got dropped because of that.
Mm-hmm.
However, the concern I'm having, or the question I'm having, is your location, the one at Fort Getty, where it's located is actually in the middle of the field. I was also told we were considering moving it on the other side of bunkers. But right now, where it is over half of the campers are going to be in your shadow flicker. And I'm not sure where you were thinking about putting the other one. So, I mean, that's the one thing I have. The second one in Fort Getty, my concern there is, I think at one point I counted 8 different things people were planning to put at Fort Getty. So I wouldn't feel comfortable saying Fort Getty until I figured out what we were doing with everything else. The people throwing out a wedding pavilion, they're talking about a sailing school. I'm not sure your second site would affect that.
I think it's important too that we prioritize what is the most benefit to the town and town's people as well. And this is one thing that we can all weigh intellectually, is forward thinking is green, provides money for the town, meets our citizens. So anyway, I agree with you, Bill, as far as goals.
That may be true, but we don't also want to limit our possibilities and potential going forward for town-owned property.
Right.
We don't want to go one.
I didn't finish my thought, because what I was also going through to say is if it starts negatively impacting the revenue from the Fort Getty campsites, then you have to put that against your model, as you're now costing the town more money, or we're losing money because we're losing our campers. So your model then becomes skewed.
I think anyone's good to discuss that, but about the shadow center, Dan is very specific about that. In this figure, this is the shadow figure for the whole year. Okay, in the summertime, the shadow flicker is much narrower and would not actually come across the campus
just right here in the summertime.
Yeah, we tried to get Dan to give us a kind of a month-by-month drawing on that, or at least a seasonal drawing on that. He had already closed the program and couldn't bring it back up. So it's, that would have been interesting to have on that, like the little line that said, here's the, you know, the time period around that. The sun, it's actually going to be, it is going to be shorter. You're going to have some of that there. I think the red thing is the fall zone.
That's the fall zone. Yeah.
And I think we have now, that's why we slowed down the Fort Getty committee to get a more comprehensive look at it, because we have a lot of competing uses for it and decisions to make of what we want to do with it. I'd like to see the flicker in the summertime when it would affect everybody, and also, you know, in this fall zone, are you prohibited from putting anything in the fall zone?
No.
This is where it might fall.
We struggled with this concept, to be frank. You know, you build a 5-story building, and the zoning ordinance doesn't require you to predict the fall zone for a 5-story building. It's sort of a myth.
Yeah.
But it's a standard component of all of these things. There's extremely few incidents in the world in which these have modern ones have fallen down. So it creates a sense of vulnerability that really is not true, I think. But it is, that's the information. If there were some explosive fuel storage in the fall zone area, that would be probably a bad idea to put it there. William's point about where the shadow flicker is in the summertime is important.
Yeah, it's very important.
I would say that one of the reasons we didn't sort of parse it in the way that Bob described it, that he did accurately do that, is at the time that we were doing these, we had been working with the Fort Getty Commission, and we thought all the trailers were moving north and down so that they'd be all out of the shadow flicker in the summertime without question. So, of course, we would have looked at it more carefully if we thought they were staying in place.
Yeah, I don't think there's been a final determination.
Yeah, we're all really impressed on that. Yeah.
I think that would have actually put more trailers in, higher percentage of trailers.
We're torn into this
in the year-round zone, but we're talking about summertime zone. It's going to be limited because the sun's higher.
Right. So just go straight down.
The turbine is at the southerly end, northerly end of Fort Getty. How does that? You look at that. That
would be a non-issue for shadow.
Right.
Because the shadow would be out of the wash.
Yeah.
You'd end up moving, I think that complicated 11 of the trailer sites would need to move to get that facility get set up, depending upon the CRC setback.
And I may comment on the interference questions. I think.